I had to say, what's wrong with me? Because I am getting stuck. I'm getting stuck in what I think should be. Or I'm getting stuck in what had happened before, and I want to repeat. I want a repeat of the Christmas from last year, not this year. I want a repeat from New Year's Eve, not this year, but last year. And I think we all have the tendency, like maybe it's the reverse. I don't want another year like this year. Or that guy, I don't want another guy like him, come hell or high water. So we're always jumping out with past history within us, claiming an old memory that we want repeated or we don't want repeated. Does that make sense to y'all? And it's called all that expectations. And then I started actually studying the word intention. I've never liked the word intention because it seems so self-promoted out of ego. You take these courses on your intention, your projection, your all that kind of stuff. And I've always been of the philosophy of let go, let God. Whatever will be, will be. And I realize there's a middle road for it all. Because if you just live in the path, whatever will be, I'll just go with the flow, then you may never have any direction or intention and be driving from Los Angeles to Phoenix your whole life and never get there. Because you're taking detours and you're going here and going there. But the initial question is, why do you want to go from Los Angeles to Tucson? Or to Phoenix, wherever it is. So then I'm reading, you know how you can read, I don't know, a travel magazine, the airplane magazine, you can read anything and one line may just get your attention. I go, wow, that's why I picked up that magazine or picked up that book. And one line that really stuck with me for this new year is pay attention to your intentions. Isn't that cool? Pay attention to your intentions. And so I look back over Christmas in New Mexico, and what was my intention? My intention was try to duplicate that which had already been. You cannot duplicate the past, and it leaves you no room for surprises, for miracles, for newness, because you see the old over and over, and you say, that's not the way it was before, or not. That's not what I wanted. And so I got it right in my face, two great experiences, Christmas and then coming here for New Year's Eve. This morning we got up, I did my sauna, we went a long walk up in the Hollywood Hills, and I realized that if I didn't pay attention to my intentions, I could really spiral downward. And I think that's sometimes what people do, they call it depression. I've never known what really depression was, except I'm getting a glimpse of that possibility and the availability for all of us if you don't pay attention to your intentions. So that's the theme for today. I also, while I was doing sadhana, I have a little box. It's a jewelry box that Krishabha bought me, and it's quite beautiful, different kinds of wood, and it has these little drawers. But I don't put jewelry in it. I put old letters that I wrote to my parents, that Wa wrote to me all the while she was in India. So I decided today's a day, because always the first Christmas holidays are remembrance, it's memory lane. So I pulled out one drawer and I picked these amazing letters that I had written, one to my father and one to my mother, about about 53 years ago, I think, for that, I'm 72, would that make it like when I was 20? And I was in Europe, and I was hitchhiking. And I had gone to Berlin, I'd won a scholarship to go to a peace conference for youth in Berlin, Germany. That was when the wall was still up, and I was like 20 years old. And 800 students gathered from all over the world to bring peace onto this earth. That was a long time ago. that the awakening had begun. It was after World War II. We were all American Field Service exchange students that had returned for this conference. And then after that, I headed out and started hitchhiking. And I could not believe the stories I was writing to my poor parents back in the Midwest in a small town in Illinois. Dear Daddy, I don't have any money, but I'm really okay. I just stick my thumb out, and I was in Bologna, and these beautiful two Italian young men picked me up, and they took me to Venice, and my father's probably thinking, oh my God. And I was a virgin. I had never done drugs. I was very innocent. And I talked so much about the flowers and the people and how we would sleep on park benches in Paris and in Geneva. And then finally, after 6 days, I would meet up with a friend or another foreign exchange student, and we decided we needed to try to find a place to stay, because obviously I'm wondering, when did I take a bath or a shower? And so we would walk for miles and finally find, we were at Bastille Day in Paris, and we found a place for $1.50 that we could share, that actually had water, running water and hot water. So it was so sweet, the letters that I wrote home. It did take me back through memory lane of how delighted I had been my whole life with life, and how grateful, because I wrote it to my parents, I'm so grateful to have you as my parents, I'm so thankful for my life, and everything is so perfect, and I don't know, it was just, it must have been my genes. Not that I didn't go through hard times, as many as you have, even contemplating suicide times, wanting to give up times. I think it's in there for all of us. I don't think anyone really can avoid it. And I think it's the darkness of the soul that we all have to travel. Maybe some more intense than others. But the question is how long you stay in it. I feel if you dwell in anything too long, you may run out of time. But some of us, I think, been down so long that it looks normal, that it looks like it's up to you, because your standards have lowered themselves down. Like, let's just say that you're drinking mildly, but it's better than perhaps what you did before. But at the same time, all kinds of habits, and not just physical habits, but emotional habits, like turning towards giving up. Hi, San Jiwan. I think there's a spot right there. So this is the time to pay attention to our intentions. And when you go south in your thoughts, chances are you're going to act out those thoughts. Is that right? Because thoughts turn to emotions. Emotions turn to action. Action creates karma. And that creates your destiny. And it started with your mind. So that's why Kundalini Yoga so dwells on cleaning the mind, getting it crisp, getting it alive, and getting it not haunting you or owning you. And if this could be the year that we announce to our minds, you own me no longer. I control my own destiny. And you are a servant of my soul. You are not the leader of my life. You are not to boss and rule me, because that's not your positioning. My position is to rule you. But it takes a daily practice, paying quite a bit of attention. Sometimes you can't know it at the moment, like I didn't know it at Christmas. I didn't know it last night. That's like a 2-week window. I didn't get it till this morning. Sometimes it doesn't come right away. But if you have a daily practice, it will keep sweeping and cleaning your mind till you'll get to core of your own truth. But if you just keep sweeping it under the rug, you'll get swept under the rug and you'll lose. You lose this whole lifetime, which is really a shame, because you were born into a country, into a prosperity. Maybe you don't think you're rich, but do some studying around the globe. And what's sitting in front of you to eat is mighty great compared to someone who sits with an empty bowl. We have such a rich life, don't throw it away. And so I ask you this year, as you start out, what are you doing as seva? Seva is selfless service with not wanting anything in return. Do you have a skill that you can offer up to others for no cost, for no exchange? Serve food, help children. It's all out there. Dogs, anybody, anything. But you have to dedicate on a weekly basis something you're doing to serve others with no return back to yourself monetarily or even a hug or slap on the back. There's so many, many, many things. I could go on and on about them. If you need any help after this class to what can I do starting this year, those who are doing service in some form or another, I'll ask you to come up and those who want to know will share. And out of that, maybe you'll find just the right niche for what you can do.